brownie points for moving forward. Perfect. Next up, not talking about PQRSA, but about libpqcrypto, is Dan Bernstein. And here's why. Go.
All right, thanks. This is another way to categorize the broken submissions. Instead of by kind of submission, you can do an ad hominem characterization, asking where the submissions came from. And there's a particular European project. There's a conference called PQCrypto, that's with capital PQC. And there's this European project, PQCrypto, all in capitals. And that one submitted 22 of the proposals to NIST, of which zero have serious attacks. And then, in fact, are there any attacks at all? Well, anyway, zero broken. And then there's the other 47 submissions, of which a third are broken. And, well, the PQCrypto project also has collected everything into a library, so that's libpqcrypto, and that you can get from libpqcrypto.org, HTTPS, of course, libpqcrypto.org, but only pre-quantum HTTPS. And that one includes 77 different systems from 19 of these 22 submissions. Of course, each submission has things like different security levels or whatever different options. So 77 systems total, 50 signature systems, 27 encryption systems. This includes much more serious testing than the NIST test framework. So this is something where if you plug in other submissions into this test framework, it'll catch all sorts of bugs which aren't caught by NIST's known answer test. There's bindings to, well, first of all, everything's in C, but then beyond that, you can use it from Python 2, Python 3, the command line. From the command line, you can use it from lots of other languages. There's also command line tools for just collecting benchmarks, seeing the size of things, the speed of things. So this is an ongoing project extending past the end of the PQCrypto project. If people have patches, suggestions for things to do, we have all sorts of internal code reorganization that we're working on, of course, making things faster on lots of different machines, improving the internal, for instance, there's like 50 different implementations of Ketchak, and that's obviously not how things should be. It should all be centralized and optimized in one implementation. So this is something which we're going to be improving moving forward. If you want to try playing with post-quantum cryptography and use a nice simple interface for it, this is just like the well-known salt, tweet salt, libsodium, supercop, etc. interface, so you'll find it easy to use, just like hundreds of other applications, and try dropping it into your application, see how well it goes. That's it. Thanks for your attention.